Indications from Washington are that the U.S. has no intentions to give up its superpower status, and the Afghan withdrawal was based on cold-blooded calculations, as China now is the new foreign policy priority for the Biden administration. The day after the Taliban seized Kabul, Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan praised the Sunni Pashtun Islamists for breaking the shackles of slavery, in an obvious reference to the U.S. military-led occupation of Afghanistan post-9/11. The Chinese, Russians, Iranians and Turks also made peace overtures and offered support to the UN-designated Sunni terrorist group in what is euphemistically called the reconstruction of Afghanistan. While the Joe Biden administration has been rightly panned by the democratic world for leaving Afghanistan in the hands of terrorists and killers, the future may not be so kosher for the deal-makers in Islamabad, Washington, and London. Even though the global credibility of the U.S. has been damaged with the Afghan withdrawal, Washington will have to compensate for this loss by action against rising challenge China if it has any intention of retaining its sole global superpower status. Perhaps this was the signal of Vice President Kamala Harris' visit to Singapore. With no military commitments left after August 31 in the Afghan capital, the U.S. and the EU will physically switch off from Kabul, and with it will dry billions of dollars of aid and funding that Pakistan was getting for its two-faced role in the war against terror in Afghanistan since 2001. While Joe Biden and Donald Trump are two ends of the political spectrum, there is bipartisan consensus over Trump's January 1, 2018, tweet where he accused Pakistan of deceit and harboring terrorists that U.S. forces were hunting in Afghanistan at that time. Pakistan would be living in a fool's paradise if it thinks that the U.S. with National Security Agency at its disposal does not know where the entire Taliban top leadership is based in Pakistan and their confabulations with Pakistan Army and ISI. After the Afghan withdrawal, neither the U.S. nor the EU needs to fund Pakistan or give them preferential status for supporting military logistics lines to Afghanistan. U.S. has funded Pakistan with over $35 billion in aid since 2001, and the EU has given more grants to Islamabad than China has given in loans. Although the Biden administration may go politically dark over the AFPAC region, the American agencies through spy satellites and communication intercepts will ensure the area is under floodlights and suppress any terror strike being plotted by the Taliban, Al-Qaeda and their terror brothers based in Pakistan. In an era of standoff weapons and missiles, counter-strike against terror plotters in this highly radicalized region can be taken with pinpointed accuracy. Taliban must not forget how their chief Mullah Mansur Akhtar was taken out by a Hellfire missile from a U.S. Predator drone in 2016 inside Pakistani territory. China, Russia and Iran are sanguine about the rise of the Taliban and virtually cheered the Deobandi Islamist force for making the U.S. run for their lives from Kabul on August 15. However, the Sunni Islamist force, weaned on perpetual jihad, has no space for either the Chinese communists, Christian Russians or Shia Iran, as all of them are kafirs. With top-of-the-line U.S. weapons at their disposal, a strong Taliban will not only reach out to their Uyghur counterparts in Xinjiang but also destabilize both Iran and Central Asian republics which buffer the Russian Federation. Pakistan will become more radicalized than ever with its Shia minority under threat, and the Taliban will put pressure on border settlement as it does not recognize the Durand line. The Chinese propaganda machine has gleefully put out narratives in the media questioning the American commitment to ASEAN and Taiwan after the collapse of Kabul. The propaganda media has taunted all the American allies in Indo-Pacific by telling them that Washington under Joe Biden has no stomach for war against the PLA Navy in the South China Sea. However, indications from Washington are to the contrary, with the Biden administration focusing on China. It is also very much possible that the Biden administration compensation towards China may turn out to be Barack Obama's Asian pivot, which was never implemented but only talked about in seminars in Singapore. Except for this time, the U.S. allies, particularly in Quad, will trust only after verification. The rise of the Taliban will also destabilize the Indian subcontinent, particularly countries like Nepal, Maldives, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka, through Islamic radicalization. While the Taliban may not be directly involved, their ideological brothers and comrades in jihad based in Pakistan will use this opportunity and new U.S. weapons to spread political Islam in the region. Clearly, blood will not dry in AFPAC battlefields for the time to come.